Should I get neuropsychological tested for my multiple sclerosis disability insurance claim? And the answer is absolutely yes, but let me explain how this should unfold. You may begin to have symptoms of MS, and ultimately these symptoms can become cognitive in nature. We want to establish a baseline of your cognitive functioning, and the way to do that is with neuropsychological testing. This will measure your ability to engage in executive functioning, such as remembering things, ordering information, sequencing information, making decisions, and ultimately doing the cognitive aspects of your occupational duties that you are paid so highly for. So I always suggest a baseline neuropsychological evaluation. As your disease progresses, your symptoms may become worse, and ultimately, in combination with your physical symptoms, be the basis for a long-term disability insurance claim. Now, before you stop work and apply for benefits, I think, again, you should be getting the neuropsychological testing. But this time, I think you should be doing it in consultation with an ERISA disability attorney such as myself. Why? Well, we want to get your disability policy and understand what the definition of your occupation is, because that's going to be the measure of your disability. You have to prove that you're unable to do the material and substantial duties of your own occupation. So we need to establish what your own occupation is based on the definition in your policy, not based on what you're doing for your employer or how it might be performed in the national economy or based on the Dictionary of Occupational Titles. We need to figure out what it is based on the definition in your policy. Why? Because ultimately we want the neuropsychologist to understand what your duties are, but more importantly, what problems you're having doing those duties. Because the neuropsychologist should be doing specific testing for the areas of deficit that you are complaining of. Ultimately, we're going to have all of this reviewed not only by your physician, but by a vocational rehabilitation counselor. Your physician will nail down the organic basis for your neuropsychological issues, those problems with executive functioning that are causing you to be unable to do the material and substantial duties of your occupation. But then ultimately we're going to have a vocational rehabilitation counselor opine from a vocational standpoint why it is those neurocognitive results impact your ability to do those executive functionings from a vocational standpoint. We need to tie this all together to submit a winning disability application. Now, if your claim is in the process of being delayed or even terminated, you need to be consulting with an attorney such as myself, again, to make sure that the medical evidence establishes a neuropsychological basis for your restrictions and limitations and ultimately your inability to perform the material and substantial duties of your own occupation or any other occupation. If you have any questions about your rights to your long-term disability benefits, call me today at 727-894-3188 for a complimentary consultation. I can help you get the disability benefits you deserve regardless of where you live in the United States.